In continuation, the next the last video, how do you calculate the measurement of conductivity? By using experimentally, how do you calculate the conductivity of ionic solution? So when you want to calculate the conductivity by using experiment, we face two problems here. Two problems we are going to face. One is called passing the DC current, direct current, which changes the composition of the solution. The solution will be affected because of the direct current here. Composition will be changed here. That means the concentration may be changed here. The solution cannot be connected to the bridge like metallic wire, other solid conductor. So we cannot connect to the bridge like metallic wire. We can't choose the metallic wire. So these are the two problems we are going to face actually. So how do you, isn't it, resolve this one? First difficulty, instead of using the DC current, use what here? Alternate current. So first problem is resolved. The second problem resolved by using specially designed vessel called conductivity cell. This is the conductivity cell we are using here, in which it is consisting of here one platinum electrode, here another platinum electrode. See, the two platinum electrodes are coated with the platinum black and they are connected. Okay, now here the having the distance, the distance between the two electrodes is what? L. And the solution confined between these two electrodes is having a column length is what? L. Area of cross section is A. So here this is the electrolyte we have taken. This is the electrolyte we have taken. In this electrolyte, isn't it? In this electrolyte, the distance between the two electrodes and the area of cross section also considered, isn't it? Now this is the experiment in which you have two platinum electrodes, electrolyte, the distance between the two electrodes, length L, and area cross section also we have taken here. Next, here when you do this formulas here, the resistance is equal to, formula already know, resistance is equal to rho into L by A, right? Now we can also write this conductivity. How do you write conductivity here? Now rho is equal to R into A by L. Okay, now 1 by rho is equal to K, that equal to 1 by R into L by A. Now this L by A is called as cell constant G star. This will be constant, okay, because the distance between the two electrodes and the area of cross section will be taken as constant. Only we change what? Electrolyte conductance will be different, electrolyte resistance is different. Okay, this will be what? G star. Okay, so cell constant is equal to what? G star is equal to L by A. Okay, we can also write like this also. K is equal to what? 1 by R into L by A. Now L by A is equal to, we can also write R into K. Okay, G star is equal to, we can write what? R into K. This is a formula generally. Okay, now I got actually L by A. Okay, I got here what actually L by A. This is very simple. Length between two electrodes, area of cross section, that we can substitute. Now when you substitute the resistance, we get the conductivity that we are actually calculating here. Now I have taken here, this is the diagram in which we are calculating the resistance R. So we substitute once R here. Okay, cell constant, that will be substituted by L and A values. Now R we need to calculate here. Now in the case of this one, once cell constant is determined, now we need to calculate what? Resistance of that solution here. Okay, otherwise what happened? Conductivity, anything it is. Okay, conductivity we are calculating what? By using the resistance. Now how to calculate the resistance? So it consists two resistance. One is R3, one is what? R3. Other is called R4. Okay, now this R3 and R4 are predefined. Okay, and one more will be there, R1. Okay, all these are what? Defined actually. Now what we are calculating here, R2 we need to calculate here. In that case what happened, we calculate unknown resistance by multiplying R1 and R4 and dividing with R3, we get R2. In this way we can calculate the R2 value. So this is about the measurement of conductivity.